Hi, my name is Ilyasah Shabazz, and I am a daughter of Malcolm X and Dr. Betty Shabazz. I wrote the foreword for Souls of My Sisters. It's an excellent book, which really serves to empower women. And it's about women who have overcome adversity of some sort, and the importance of sharing our stories so that we can empower other people.
Souls of My Sisters has been released. We have worked, talked with, traveled, met thousands and thousands of women, and we've significantly made a difference in their lives.
Through this journey with Candace, I've met so many women who look so very different and have so many different feelings and emotions, but knowing that we're interconnected, I think that was the biggest mission Candace and I had. We've met just a phenomenal group of women, and we look forward to meeting more women and sharing our stories and their stories with you.
What I've been through should have killed somebody else. Yes, I was in mental institutions, yes, I was in jail, but I shouldn't have been able to survive that. So yes, I know there's a God, and that's how I found him, through experience.
When I was in my 20s, I lost both my parents within almost 2 years apart. And it was a hard battle, but I was so fortunate to have great parents, you know. My mother was great. It took me a long time to recover, but I am who I am because of them and because of what happened to me yesterday.
Statements that people made, I believed them, like I was going to die. It was a death sentence, and it was a death sentence for me. Personally, it was a death sentence, because I was going to kill myself before the AIDS would kill me. Because fear will kill you before the disease will. I strongly believe that any disease that you have, if you're not knowledgeable and not educated about it, that you will die mentally, and you will die physically, and you will die spiritually.
I remember being a little girl and always feeling awkward and out of place. I was always so tall. And I was dark skinned, and a lot of my family members are really light skinned. And back in the 60s growing up, that was a major thing, the light skinned, dark skinned thing. It seemed that all of the beautiful women, or all the women that were deemed beautiful, were really light complected.
And my father was wonderful, hardworking, and as he needed companionship. At the time, I never knew what this meant or what was happening to him. But he struck up a relationship with my mother's first cousin. I was very confused, not knowing what was happening, but something was happening that didn't make things right for me.
I couldn't believe that I could be arrested, because I never really touched any drugs or did anything with any drugs. I was arrested on conspiracy, conspiring to violate the narcotic laws, which I'd never heard of anything like that before. And especially conspiring with your own husband, how do you do that, you know? So that put a fear in me. Whereas today, you know, like, I'll tell anyone, if they want you, they got you.
So, yes, Souls of My Sisters continues to be a part of a reality in my life that I could not handle alone.